Hi, my name is Gabriel. I'm a mental health worker for the Migrant Worker Community Program. Today we will be discussing masculinity. Thank you so much for joining us. This project is funded by the Canadian Mental Health Association. All of our social media will be linked below, so make sure to check that out. Let's begin. We'll begin by defining toxic masculinity. Toxic masculinity is a term used to describe a harmful set of beliefs referring to how men should conduct themselves in society. These beliefs stem from traditional, unrealistic stereotypes of men. Toxic masculinity is not saying that all behaviors of men are toxic, rather that some masculine ideals are harmful to women, other men, and everyone else. Toxic masculinity asserts that in order to be considered a real man, men must behave and look a certain way. Some stereotypical expectations of men include being tall, very muscular, hyper-independent, wealthy, and participating in risky behaviors such as reckless driving, smoking, heavy drinking, and fighting. But this cannot be further from the truth. Being a man is not defined by conforming to the physical or emotional stereotypes associated with manliness. Being a man is defined by your values, being comfortable with who you truly are, and expressing your emotions, rather than trying to fit into what society thinks you should be. Three components of toxic masculinity. Toughness. The belief that men should be physically strong, emotionally distant, and aggressive. Anti-femininity. The idea that men should not participate in any feminine behaviors. Those being nurturing children, being affectionate, or displaying emotions. The third component of toxic masculinity is power. The idea that in order to gain respect, men must work towards obtaining power through wealth and status. Catering to these harmful components associated with toxic masculinity can be exhausting and make you feel pressured. Toxic masculinity also discourages self-care. This applied stigma on self-care results in men participating in behaviors that can have a negative impact on their health in order to be more manly. Some of these behaviors include ignoring and pushing through serious physical pain, consuming an unhealthy diet, excessive alcohol and tobacco use, and reckless driving. Toxic masculinity also dismisses the idea of mental health and perceives those who suffer from mental illness to be weak. This can cause many negative mental health outcomes, such as making men feel weak for sharing their feelings and expressing emotion. It can discourage men from seeking mental health treatment, may promote the use of drugs and alcohol as a coping mechanism, and reduce the willingness to reach out and get mental help, increasing the likelihood of suicide. Suicide among men is 3 times higher than in women, and is the highest cause of death of men under 45. Alcohol-related cirrhosis of the liver is 2 times higher in men than in women. Additionally, men account for 75% of driving-related injuries as a result of reckless driving or impaired driving. Healthy masculinity is the idea that men can be emotionally expressive, have female friends or mentors, and express their emotions without feeling emasculated. According to research, when men are under stress, they often lead towards negative coping skills such as drinking, smoking, anger, and violence. One of the many reasons why men use these coping skills is due to the presence of toxic masculinity being prevalent in society. We will talk about some of the ways men can cope in a healthy manner. When you are feeling overwhelmed by emotions, it is important to realize that you can cope in a healthy way instead of lashing out. By taking deep breaths, you give yourself a second to be grounded and focus on the now and gain a better perspective on the overall situation. Suppressing your feelings can lead to bottling them up, which can lead to anger and outbursts in the long run. It is good to be aware of your emotions by allowing yourself to feel them and work towards developing emotional intelligence. Allow yourself to express your emotions through crying, exercise, or any activity that will let you express how you feel. Self-love is a state of appreciation for oneself that grows from actions that support our physical, psychological, and spiritual growth. Self-love means having a high regard for your own well-being and happiness. Be proud of who you are and what you like. Don't worry about trying to conform to stereotypical expectations of men. Loving and accepting yourself is a journey. It does not happen overnight. It's a process. Self-love can look different for every individual. Sometimes self-love is painting or listening to music. Other times self-love is challenging yourself with new goals that can help you step out of your comfort zone. The more that you get in touch with yourself, the more confident you will become with your masculinity. Compassion is derived from the Latin word compati, which means suffering together. Emotion researchers describe compassion as a feeling that emerges when we are faced with another person's suffering and feel the desire to alleviate their pain. Compassion makes it possible for you to feel the struggles of men and others that have been affected by toxic masculinity in a similar way. Practicing healthy masculinity encourages men to model positive relationship skills such as active listening, communication, non-judgmental support, and asking for help. When men practice healthy masculinity, they are more likely to call out men who are participating in disrespectful behaviors. Healthy masculinity makes it easier for men to care for themselves, acknowledge when others need help, and promote inclusivity for all genders. Additionally, men who are more connected with their emotions will experience increased life satisfaction and self-esteem, and decreased rates of mental health problems such as depression. How to model healthy masculinity. Don't be afraid to be wrong. A harmful mindset of toxic masculinity is, real man always makes calculated decisions. Men should be okay with accepting that they are wrong when they are, and seek help when it is needed. Show your emotions. Men neglect to show their emotions because they are afraid of looking weak. However, suppressing your emotions and feelings can be incredibly detrimental to a man's mental health. Support and display diverse interests. Toxic masculinity asserts that certain hobbies or types of music are more manly. Though there's nothing wrong with traditionally manly hobbies, boys should know that their hobbies are just as acceptable for men. Be confident about your male identity, no matter your interests. A man who paints is just as much as a man as one who watches sports. Please do not hesitate to familiarize yourself with these essential resources for your well-being and mental health. Thank you for listening. Feel free to send us questions and/or comments regarding this topic on Facebook.